Good morning, guys. I'm out with Troy. We're down here at Clackamette Park. And we're gonna see what this shad run's all about. It's mid-June. As you can tell, they're running thick. I love that rainbow when they come out of the water. It looks so cool. Do you want it filmed? All right, let me reel this one in.
Also, if you want to get some, have you seen them out there? Of course you
have. Whoa, dude!
Oh, shit.
What the hell, dude? Look at that, guys. All right, guys. Troy and I are just shad fishing, and right there is Steelt's chilling out. Check out this footage. Man, that was a cool thing to see. Oh, there we go. Yep. Oh yeah, first one. Woo, it's cooking down. Bam! Bam! Oh, dude, the hook popped right out. Almost hit me in the face. All right, on the board, June Shad Run, ladies and gentlemen.
Just being by myself, you know, it's different when you're fishing.
Yeah.
But I really was just kind of watching as the tide was going out. Yeah.
Yep. That felt like a snag. Anyway, tide going out.
I was just watching the waves.
This is a good one. Maybe the other way around. One of them you fish the troughs, one of you fish the sandbars. Guys, second June run, Willamette River, American Shad Run, all that good stuff on the bare green shad dart. He keeps kicking me in the arm. Alright guys, second American Shad on the board. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe to me in Detroit. We're out here getting some of these good sturgeon and crab bait. These guys are fun. Look at the mouth on that guy. Ooh, whoa! Back to it. Alright guys, I did this in my last video, but I'm going to show you again how to rig up for this since I broke off, so might as well. So, rod I'm using, 6'6". Medium. We got Stradic 4000 on here. Oh, just hitting Troy's stuff. And then main line is 20-pound braid. Tying on a snap swivel. And then we're taking 12-pound Floro. I'm doing about arm's length. Before you tie on, I'm gonna open this snap and put this 3/4 ounce weight on it. So you got their weight on there. You're going to tie to the other part of that swivel. So this is a shad dart. It's just a chartreuse shad dart. Was it 1/32nd, right?
1/32nd.
Yep. So 1/32nd. Damn. Dude, he just, I was looking at him landing one, and then I... Boys, we on him. We on him. Man, he hit the heart. Yeah, eat. And like that, we are on. I was going to fly that drone and you guys both hooked up, so they must thought a big line was coming through, so. Just let him break you off. Oh. He didn't break me off, but he popped off. Son of a... I think I cast right on top of your fish.
Right down there at the end of that slot, if you stay kind of on top of the water until you get towards the end of the slot down here, and then real, real slow. I mean, like.
Wait, I think we both just got one. Wait, I have one? What the hell? Never mind, I got one. I thought that was your fish. What? I thought the thumping was me hitting your line, but no, I got a fish. Did you get that?
Yeah.
Dude, I thought it landed on his line, so I was just sitting there and I set it and it started.
I was really confused on this catch, but. I think this is probably my PB so far. Maybe?
Yeah, maybe. 2.5, 3.25, maybe.
Look at these guys.
I think it's quite...
Tarpon mouth. Fishing with just that little jig right there. Awesome. I think they're running a school right now, so I'm gonna get back out there. Last keeper though.
Curious to see how much this guy weighs. I'm gonna say 2.5.
Two point seven.
Too many fish in the cool. Whoa! I dropped it.
All right, go ahead.
Look at all the fish. Boom. Bunch of shad. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are calling it an afternoon. We killed it compared to last time. I think, Troy, what do you got, 7?
Yeah,
eight?
I had 7.
I had about 5 or 6, and I lost about 2 or 3. So, super good day compared to last time. Here's a little haul. All those guys. Oh, oh God, it sticks. Oh, God. Oh, I had to. They don't smell good. They stink, and that's why they're going to be sturgeon and crab bait. I'm not sure if I'm going to do another shad trip. I just wanted to cross them off my list and then get one good day, so this was kind of my good day. The bite's kind of interesting for these guys. It'll be dead for a while and then all of a sudden it'll be on. Like Troy was saying in his video, they kind of run in just like selective schools, I'm guessing, or pods. They come and go and you just got to get in them when they're there, but when you do, everyone's hooking up and it's a pretty good fight. If you guys haven't caught one of these, come down. I mean, I showed you how to do it. It's pretty simple. Clackamette Park, pretty public spot, so be sure you're casting correctly or you're gonna snag up with people. So yeah, shad is it's a pretty smelly, stinky fish, so it's really good, like I said, for crab and sturgeon. And you're gonna save a lot of money on buying chicken and fish
So come down here, catch, there's no limit, so get, I don't know, 10, 15 fish, freeze them, and you got bait for whenever you need to go out. We're gonna get out of here. Be sure to check this dude out. But as you guys know, that giveaway was to help support him and get more recognition, because he deserves it just as much as I do. So thank you all for helping
thanks, buddy.
Support this guy, because it's a pretty incredible little movement we did. But all that being said, thank you for watching again, and I hope to catch you and some fish with this dude in a future video.
Peace.
Send it.
Oh.
Like the cool blue light. Like the cool blue light. Like the cool blue light. Like the cool blue light.